Section 3. Rock, Paper, Scissors. In this section, we will be creating a game to play with Node.js. Interesting, isn't it? Video 3.1. Introduction to the project. In this video, we will look at the idea and outline of our project. By now, you would have figured out. We are going to recreate the hand game Rock, Paper, Scissors. And guess what? We will be playing it with Node.js. How cool is that? I'm excited. So, how do you think we can play a game with Node.js? After all, it's just a programming tool. So, how can we accomplish this? Let's think. The only components we have are Node.js and our hands. First, how would Node.js know what sign I'm showing? So, we need a camera which sends images or video to Node.js. Let's go with images. Okay, where would we connect the camera? We need a Raspberry Pi. Note that here, I will be running Node.js on my Raspberry Pi. I have a question. How would Node.js recognize what sign I am showing? Lakshna, you are repeating the question. Oops, sorry. How would Node.js recognize the different signs I am showing? We need an image recognition tool linked with our Node.js to identify the different signs. So, are we going to create it? No. We are going to use the one that the IBM Cloud has. It is called the IBM Watson Visual Recognition Service. We'll see it in detail in the next video. This service would return a value that tells us the exact sign we show in front of the camera at that instance. Once that is ready, then we are going to use that data to compare with the random values generated by Node.js and find out who wins. We also have to log the scores in a database for calculating the top scorer. Likewise, we can add many features to our game. Everything seems to be clear, but how do we see the scores? We will be using the dashboard nodes to display everything. So, what are you waiting for? Let's start. In this video, we defined the idea of the project. In the next video, we will look at the platform we will use for analytics.